Look at everything they did. You know, they locked you down. They told you you couldn't do this. They told you you couldn't do that. You can't go to supermarkets. You can't go to restaurants. You can't go to the beach. You can't go to the parks. But, oh, go and protest for Black Lives Matter. Yes, we'll let you do that because it's a noble cause. If the pandemic was real and the was real, they would never have approved the protests, folks. I can't say it's, oh, it's a noble cause, so the virus has gone away. If there was, they wouldn't have approved the protests. I mean, it should be so obvious to people. I don't know why people can't get it. It should be obvious to them. How many of the announcers you see on the news are even real? How much of what you see on television is real at all, folks? Now, isolation is one of the most cruelest forms of punishment that they do to people in prison. What they're doing is they're putting the entire world into prison with these ridiculous rules that they're putting in place. So you can't just say, well, that's no good, I'm not going there, and walk away. You've got to complain about it. You've got to say to them, I want to see the manager. I want to talk to the manager. I want to know who's putting these rules in place, because this is reckless endangerment of the public health. It's psychological abuse of children. If this is being done by someone calling themselves an education minister, we need the name of this education minister so they can explain themselves to us, because this is psychological abuse of children. This is reckless endangerment of the public health on so many levels, not just physically, but also emotionally, psychologically. When you go to these places such as a Ventura County shopping center where you actually have to wear a mask to enter the shopping center, tell them, well, no, actually, it's bad for my health to wear a mask. So if you're claiming that I have to do something that's bad for my health in order to enter your establishment, this is reckless endangerment of the public health. I'd like to know who gave you that order. And then, you know, get your manager. And then the manager comes out, say, well, I'd like to know where the legislation comes from. I need the name of the politician because I want to press charges against them for reckless endangerment of the public health. And then ring up that politician's office and say, what you're doing is reckless endangerment of the public health. Can you show cause or you should not be held accountable and prosecuted for what you're doing?
That's what they're doing, folks. That's what they want to do with this whole push for the vaccines as well. And think about the vaccines, folks. There's no way you could develop a vaccine this quickly. It takes years to develop vaccines. You know, and I don't think any of them work anyway. All of them are just full of this ridiculously toxic stuff. You know, even to support the whole concept of vaccines, you've got to support germ theory, which I don't. So, you know, I think there's a lot to be said for that. But anyway, getting off topic a little bit, the fact that they've been able to develop these vaccines so quickly and they're pushing the vaccines so quickly and they say the vaccines are the only way out of the situation we find ourselves in shows that that's the real agenda. The vaccines have already been there. Whatever it is they're putting in these vaccines, we've already established that, you know, they're saying it's an RNA vaccine. It's going to modify your DNA, going to modify your RNA. You know, so it's about genetic manipulation. It's about leading us into the mainframe. It's a whole new reality they want to unfold, folks. And the concept that the second wave is really, you know, going to be noticed, people will pay attention to the second wave. I would suggest the testing has a lot to do with what's going to create the second wave. I mean, what is the reason for these tests? Why are they sticking these swabs so far up people's noses? If the virus was really as contagious as they say, so contagious that they're going to make you wear a mask, surely they could just take a sample of your breath. Surely they could just take a little swab of saliva from the corner of your mouth and they could test it to see what viral load you had in your body. They would be able to identify it from that. The fact that they need to stick these swabs all the way up your nose, but they're asking you to wear masks at the same time, this is very contradictory, folks. And, you know, you look at the state of the United States at the moment, the food shortages, everything that's going to be coming. And that's the main thing through this, you know, is the food shortages. And I'll come back to that in a minute. But as I've said on so many previous occasions, they're falsifying the figures through all this as well. There's actually a report I saw on one of Jeff's videos, Jeff Berwick's videos, the Dollar Vigilante, and it mentioned a guy who died in a motorcycle crash, but he was on the death list. And when it was questioned, they didn't take him off the death list. And the official, whoever it was, his explanation as to why they didn't take him off the COVID death list, that, well, they've got to question whether perhaps it was the COVID that caused him to have the motorcycle accident. I mean, you can't make this stuff up, folks. They're just using anything they can and saying it's a death. You know, and they're even doing mainstream news reports now saying, oh, you know, not many people have died from the flu this year because of all the measures we've taken to protect ourselves from COVID. We've saved all these people's lives from flu deaths. That's why there's no flu deaths this year. No, folks, all the flu deaths are still happening. They're just recategorizing it as 10. That's the way they do it, folks, and the way they've done with this motorcycle accident. But as I said, the real problem that we're facing here is the coming food shortage. And they're talking about that here in Australia now as well. They're saying, well, there's been a breakdown of the supply chain and we may be facing food shortages in the future. Just suggesting it, getting you prepared for it, folks. There's the main target, as I've said, in this whole thing is North America, Canada and the United States are going to be facing massive food shortages. The amount of farms that have been just trashed through Montana, the crops being ploughed back into the ground, the meat not getting transported to market, the cattle having to be killed. You know, the United States has been importing meat, which is, you know, absolutely ridiculous that it should be doing that, importing steak. So that's what we're going to be facing, folks. And it's important that people, if you're awake, you start stocking up on supplies and getting yourself to high ground. Get out of the cities if you can.
What does a magician want you to do when he's doing a trick? He wants you to look at the hand that's not doing the trick so you don't see the hand that's doing it.
They just want human consciousness to go in a certain way.
Problem, reaction, solution.
Problem, reaction, solution, ladies and gentlemen. That's how they do it.
You create the problem. You get the reaction from the public on the basis of the way you've explained the problem, which is not actually what happened. And then you offer the solutions to the problems you have created.
Something else that I said, problem, reaction, solution, was that the protests, they needed the protests in order to justify the second wave.
Bang! What's the matter? Protests, pulling down statues. The whole focus of attention has gone somewhere else. There are other reasons for that, but it's taken the focus away. When the real focus should be, look at the economic devastation of these lockdowns on every community. That should be the focus. This happened just at the right time that they wanted it to get exactly the reaction that they wanted. So maybe there's more to know about this, and it's not just only what you see. And I think there is more to come out about all that. I really do.
When you look at things such as the Industrial Revolution and you look at the periodic changes that society goes through every 50 to 100 years, even more so every 200 years, there's always a birth of a new reality comes from the one before, a new beginning, if you will. But what is the new beginning we're moving into? It's really going to be a reality that is totally controlled by AI. If we're not careful. And you know, the politicians, I don't even think the politicians know exactly what they're doing. I think too many people who've been involved in setting this up really bargained for what they were going to be getting. It's like all the rock stars and the pop stars and all the superstars and all the sports stars and all these people that have kept society distracted for so many years. I said to you a few weeks ago, the Miley Cyruses and the Madonnas and all these people that have been used to keep us distracted, they're all finding themselves on equal par now. You know, that video that Madonna did in the bath when she was saying, wow, we're all equal now. If one goes down, we all go down. You know, synonymous with the whole of society. I mean, because all the people, all the rock stars and all the people that they paid all these exorbitant amount of money to keep us distracted, they don't care about them. They're all going down too. I said that a few weeks ago, you know, it'd be a bit of a shock for these people to find themselves all locked in their own houses, all having to deal with social distancing. Forget all that rock star world, all the pop star world, concerts and sports games and all that sort of stuff. It's not going to happen, folks. It's not going back to normal. People think that, you know, this is just a temporary thing. No, it's not. Do everything you can to get the word out to people, folks, because there's nothing more important than this issue. Our whole world is changing. It's not going to go back. We're at a time in history where we find ourselves on the front line, all of us. We're on the front line here, folks. That's the thing. A lot of people just don't realize. World War III has already started. It's a war that's being waged against the people of the world by the politicians of the world. The problem is the people don't realize it's happening. This response to this social isolation, this removal of even our oxygen, we're not wearing masks, this is such folks. Like I said, it's complete. Everything they're doing to us is to make us sick, folks. And that will be your second wave. And the second wave will be fear and paranoia driven more than anything else. I mean, the first wave is fear and paranoia driven. I mean, how can they even have a second wave? There wasn't a first wave. There hasn't ever been a... It's all been about this legislation. It's all been about this police state. The whole thing, ladies and gentlemen, these parasitic morons that we have masquerading as government. What matters is that we realize what's happening and we realize the steps we need to take to get ourselves out of what's happening.